Mechanical keyboards. They are tactile, clicky, and just so satisfying to type on. And I love them so much, in fact, I have two of them. And yes, the RGB is not optional. They just feel right, and even writing the script is a pleasure. But they have one big disadvantage, and this is they are noisy as hell. Which is part of the fun, yes, but not if your partner sleeps in the same room while you are typing, editing, coding, gaming, or searching for porn. But you can fix this. All you need to do is add these little rubber ringies here under your keycaps. You can find them on Amazon or eBay for a couple of bucks. Just make sure they are transparent or white if you have a fancy RGB keyboard. Let's do it! You can pull off the keycaps with your fingers, but I highly recommend using a keycap pull thing. This way is way more convenient. And it only will take you 6 minutes to print. What? You do not own a 3D printer? Well, then just like me, buy one from eBay. They are really cheap. But this will apparently take longer than 6 minutes. But we already waited half a month for the rubber thingies to arrive, so that's not too bad. We are starting by simply pulling the keycap like this. Make sure to align the pulley right with both sides of the keycap. It will click 2 times and then you can pull the keycap straight up. I also added some tape to the pulley to make sure it does not scratch my caps. Of course, you do not want your cat. Because you don't want your caps to scratch. Then you just need to repeat the steps 104 times and you're done. Or as in my case, you can simply skip the numpad. Because who uses that anyway? After this, you realize how disgusting your keyboard has become and you rush into the kitchen to clean all the keycaps and wash them with lots of good old soapy soap. And if you have any left, which I unfortunately have not, so I just used my shower gel because this is really good at cleaning me, which should be good at cleaning rests of me from other things. After this, you dry them with a towel, realize you won't get them completely dry, and then let them dry overnight. Well, using your PC tonight is not an option anymore. Except for me, because remember, 2 keyboards! Who's the one now? Weißt du, ob das zu viel ist, zu cringy, oder ob es genau richtig cringy ist? Also, please give your keyboard a good shake. After this, you can wash it in your dishwasher. I do not trust my dishwasher, I never know what's happening inside. So you just can give it a good wipe with some Waschlappen.
Washcloth.
Make sure you get every row with all the nasty chips and skin flakes cleaned up. Well, this looks so much better now. Fast forward to the next day. All your keycaps are dry now and we are ready to assemble it all. This is when the O-rings come into play. You just place them around the plus-shaped standoffs inside the keycap. Then you place the keycap on its place and repeat steps 104 times again. And you're done. So now we have a fresh and clean keyboard and it's also way more silent than before. Let's have a listen. This is not enough evidence for you? Well, I also have this.
Decibel meter.
So, this is my decibel meter. This is like the background noise right now. This is my voice. Yeah. If I completely This is the floor noise. It's around 77, 76 decibel. So let's have a try. First, with no rubber. So, with no O-rings here. As you can see, we go up as 84. You can also use the max value here. Ooh, 89.5. Let's go over here and have a look at the rubber O-rings. So first we'll reset. So here the max value was 83. So it's a lot quieter. You still need more evidence? Well, time for the girlfriend test. Okay, that's all for today. I think this was a great success. Thanks for staying until the end. The next video will be epic. I'm making a custom portable horn-loaded subwoofer, which will be crazy loud, crazy big, crazy long battery life and crazy expensive. So subscribe if you don't want to miss out. And I see you on the next one.